This is the design equation of the boost converter. Here you can see that the power of the converter is 250 watts and then input voltage is 12 volt. Switching frequency is 10 kilohertz and output voltage is 20. From that you have to calculate Iode max, ripple current, ripple voltage, and then inductor for that boost converter and capacitor and then load resistance. Okay, so here I'm going to simulate this one. So these are the value for a boost converter, that means inductor, capacitor, resistance. Okay, the same value is going to be used for this modeling that boost converter in the Simulink, right? So here you can see that inductor and capacitor. Here you can see the capacitor value and then our load resistance. So here we are using variable voltage, so it will be changed every 0.5 second, 10, 12 and 11, 12, right? So next you have to measure output voltage here and then compare with reference voltage. So our reference voltage requirement is 20 volt. So you have to compare with this reference voltage and process via this PID controller. And then here you have to use feedback generator, having 10 kilohertz frequency. And then output going to be given to this MOSFET. So it going to control this MOSFET and have to maintain voltage around 20 volt in the load side, right? So here we need to train this PID controller. So here I'm going to use PID controller. So when you have to use PID controller, so the value of that, I'm going to use PA controller now. Okay, so when you take the value will be 1 1, when you directly take that value is normally in between 1 1. So we need to tune this value, right, according with our output, right? Now I'm fixing at 1 1 and then check the response. So now you can see that the voltage, output voltage not track that our reference command, right? It's around only 10 volt, right? That means voltage regulation not happen in the circuit, right? So further we need to go for tuning. So just go to click this one and then click this tune parameter, right? This. After clicking that one, you will get another window, tuning window. So here you will get this kind of window and then go to this plant, right? Plant, and then click identify new plant. So after clicking that one, so we need to take input output, right? So for that I'm going to generate data, simulate the data. So just go to click this simulate data. So here you can see that that mean, so this value, right, the value of this, that mean input to the PWM inverter, so sorry, PWM generator is going to act as input. So this is going to act as the output, the error going to act as the output. So you have to identify that error output, so based upon some input data. So here we have to provide duty cycle here. So I'm going to fix offset duty cycle is 0.2, and then the amplitude offset, that mean amplitude of the change in duty cycle, I'm going to fix 0.3. then you will get here, right? So the change of duty cycle from 0.2 to 0.5, right? So next I'm going to simulate the model. You have to identify the data of the plant. Okay, so we need to make a transfer function for our boost converter by using this logic. Okay, so for that we need to simulate this Simulink model in order to get the data, to identify the data. Okay, so here you can see that, so it's simulating the model and then gathering the data. So now we can see here that we are obtaining the data here, right? So this is the identity data for the given input. So next I'm going to apply this data and then close. So next we move to the plant identification. So next we go to identify the plant, like we have to identify the plant as a transfer function. So here you can see that structure, right? So we can use different kind of structure, right? To 1 pole, 2 real 4 underdamped pair. So anything you can use. So better you can use underdamped pair. Okay. And then just you go to click this auto estimate. So it automatically estimate the transfer function. Okay. So transfer function for our system. Okay. So next you go to, so you will get exact, not exact, is nearer to the tower. Identified data. Okay, so next you got to apply this transfer function. So after applying this one, you will get some value here, and then here also you'll you see that response of this system, right? So next you go to PID tuner, right? PID tuner, and then click add plot. Add plot and then click reference tracking. Just go to come below that body plot, just click reference tracking. So after clicking that one, just check this show parameter. So here you can see that the gain margin is not finite, right? It is infinity. So try to make that gain margin is finite, right? So after that you got to adjust the this two slider, right? This one you can adjust these two. So now we can see that so this is a block reference, and the dotted line is a block reference, that means response. So this response not nearer to the unity, but after tuning, right, this goes to that mean unity response, right? And also you can check the gain margin. So we are getting the gain margin is finite, right? Just you go to update this value, update that KPKA, and then check the response. Okay, just you have to check the response of the system. So now we can see that, so it attained that maximum, that mean our reference voltage command, right? And also it track the reference voltage, right? You can see that. So this is a way of tuning that PID parameter by using this block, right? So we are fixing that reference is 20, and also you can see here the command is, that mean it tracking the voltage at the 20, even though it change in input voltage, right? So you can see that voltage from change from 10 to 12 and then 12 to 11, 11 to 12, right? Even though changing voltage, input changing, so the load voltage is maintained at 20 volt. So this is the working of this tuning of PID controller for boost converter. Thank you.